Hi, everyone, and thanks for joining us for our latest Spotlight conversation, where we're going to explore some of the latest news and advances in artificial intelligence and machine learning, and how we're harnessing some of those amazing new capabilities to shape our employee experience here at Microsoft. I'm joined today by Rajamma Krishnamurthy, a principal PM architect here in Microsoft Digital, who recently took on a new role leading our efforts to incorporate AI into our solutions and experiences. Rajamma, we're all hearing a lot about generative AI, the technology that powers ChatGPT and the ChatGPT capabilities within Microsoft's Bing search engine. These technologies have really captured the world's attention in ways that past AI and ML solutions haven't. What's changed, in your opinion, to make these new AI chatbots so much more interesting and engaging?
First of all, hi, Keith, and hi, everyone. Let's talk about ChatGPT. Suddenly, we have an AI that's trained to recognize patterns in vast volumes of text that was harvested from the internet and then further trained by human assistants. And now it's delivering much more useful, meaningful conversations, prose, and even poetry. Now, with this ability to string words in a more meaningful way, and AI is now a lot more, I would say, human and engaging. And with these, now we can have, the Bing example is we can have better search, more complete answers, a conversational experience, and insights that we never thought search could ever bring in our past.
It is pretty amazing. I actually used Bing recently to produce a poem that I included in my son's birthday card, so already a practical use of technology. Do you see specific ways that we could incorporate generative AI chat within our employee experience at Microsoft?
Do you have an hour to talk to me about this? So let's take some examples. Let's start with the very first time an employee enters, the job descriptions themselves. They can be generated with generative AI. The person that is interviewing you, that those transcripts can be transferred into a feedback that can be further put into the system based on the additional inputs from the interviewer. There could be interview coaching, let's say performance or connect writing, as we call it, a review that writes itself, self-service on support tickets. My laptop is not working. The conference room is not working, I need some help with something. And then, of course, anything coaching and on-demand coaching, well-being and mental health support. And I could go on and on about this.
Those are all amazing scenarios. And as a Microsoft employee, a review that writes itself certainly sounds appealing to me. But thinking beyond just generative AI, what are some of the other ways that AI and ML can be harnessed to improve the employee experience?
I would say the entire life cycle. And when I think about it, I was thinking about everything, everywhere, all at once, I guess, based on the Oscars we just saw recently. So let's start again at the very beginning of the life cycle of an employee, matching your skills to a job or a project at a company or at Microsoft, finding mentors, communities, and subject matter experts that you need to connect to do your job better. You're creating a career plan for you, learning recommendations. Again, I talked about the whole support scenarios. And, ML can, and AI can help prescribe and predict solutions based on employee feedback and or employee daily pulses that we have. Of course, a personalized onboarding and offboarding. It's almost like, white glove service for you when you come on board. And offboarding is equally important from an employee experience perspective. So again, a vast plethora of things that we can do. And I'm not even counting if you're wearing hats of, a manager, or if you're wearing a hat of an HR professional or a sales professional or a developer. I mean, the amount of support that you can get from AI is countless at this point.
Yeah. Those are all amazing scenarios. So one of the challenges with AI and ML solutions is that they can reinforce biases that exist in the data sets that they're trained from. We saw that previously with Microsoft Tay, which is a bot that we launched several years ago, that very quickly demonstrated that it had a lot of biased information that informed the way that it interacted with users. How are we dealing with biases in the very large data sets that we're using to train these new models at Microsoft?
Great question. Did you know that there are more than 25 odd different kinds of bias that you can introduce while using AI or ML, especially with large data sets? From the very beginning of how you choose your data to doing the training of the models or the testing of the models, and even after the you the outcomes of the models, or when you productize it, the decisions that you make based on those models are all, you know, candidates for getting into a bias situation. An example I would say is like in healthcare, where there was an insurance company that created a model to study the intervention in healthcare based on the cost or the expense of somebody, you know, expense as of the healthcare, basically cost of healthcare. What it failed to understand was people that were spending on healthcare were not the people that didn't even have access to healthcare. So you suddenly did not include the people that were supposed to get, you know, you left out a large population. So keep considering that. So the best way to avoid these kind of issues is by building explainability throughout the data pipeline. The key is to build the transparency and a very strong governance process. From choosing of the data sets to transparency of the AI model itself. And of course, the monitoring of the outcomes after we put it into production. So the job is never done when it comes to AI applications, even after you go into production.
Yeah, good insights. So I can imagine a lot of IT professionals and developers are probably wondering how they can sharpen their AI and ML skills. Do you have any tips for people who are looking to brush up or maybe learn something new so they can better take advantage of AI and ML in their companies?
There is so much to learn. There is so much information out there. You know, especially in these days where there are lots of free information available, whether it's on the internet, through LinkedIn, through Coursera, through and for Microsoft professionals, even within Microsoft, so many AI ML communities that have now collated a lot of useful information that you can learn from. Our own organization, we are actually trying to figure out by discipline, what are the foundational level of information that you need to understand AI? More importantly, how do you use responsible AI, the examples that we talked about? And then how do you build upon those based on the discipline you have? If you're a designer, how do you learn and use AI versus if you are a developer, how do you use it? And if you're a PM differently and so on. So there are many aspects of AI that each discipline needs to learn. And we are trying to kind of build up that curated course learning path.
Yeah, I think that's a challenge that companies and organizations are facing everywhere, especially in light of some of these real breakthroughs that we've seen recently. Yeah. Okay, one last question for you. Some people that I've talked to are afraid of AI. Others are excited. In your opinion, should we be frightened or excited about the future of AI, or maybe something completely different?
I think we should always be excited about new technology and new tools, but we should all also be, I wouldn't say afraid, but be very, very careful, because anything new, we will always ignore the people that we have always ignored. You know, if you're talking about any automations, the historical patterns of when it wasn't automated will continue if you rely on the past history. We have to be excited about the what and the why of these tools, but the how and the who we are going to affect, we need to be very carefully studying that.
Brilliant. Rajamma, I always learn so much whenever I get to talk to you. Thanks for joining me today.
Thank you, Keith, and thank you, everyone.